So welcome all to the topic nucleic acid, which contains classification. The syllabus contains classification, purine and pyrimidine bases, structure of DNA and RNA, functions of nucleic acid, DNA replication, biosynthesis of proteins, test for DNA and RNA, and effect of hydrogen bonding in biological systems. As an introduction, it was Swiss physician and chemist Friedrich Miescher isolated a material from the nucleus of pus cells, which were present in a pus containing bandages, and named it as nuclein. The substance was quite different from carbohydrate, fats, proteins, etc., and was found to be acidic in nature. And it contained large proportions of phosphates. And later, in 1889, the scientist Altman named the substance as nucleic acid. So later studies showed that nucleic acid, there's a presence of sugar component as well as nitrogen-based components. So we all know that the basic fundamental unit of a living organism is cell. A cell contains a nucleus, and the nucleus consists of genomes, which contains 23 pairs of chromosomes. Okay, 23 pairs of chromosomes, and each chromosome contains a large strand of DNA tightly packed around a protein called histones. So within the DNA, there are sections called genes. So usually these genes contain instructions for making proteins. I will explain more detail regarding during genetic coding. So you can see that a cell contains a nucleus. Nucleus comprises of chromosomes. From chromosomes contains a closely packed DNAs. So a segment of DNA which carries the genetic information, or which are responsible for protein synthesis, is called gene. Okay, a part of DNA is called gene. Okay. Now, I can say the main function of nucleic acid is to store and transmit genetic information. So there are classification. There are two types of nucleic acid. Mainly, generally, it is classified of two. Generally, that is deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA, and ribonucleic acid, RNA. So usually this DNA is found in the nucleus, whereas RNA is found throughout the cell. So as a basic information regarding the structure, RNA is a single strand. Okay, it's a single nucleotide chain. A nucleotide comprises of phosphate. Okay, comprises of a phosphate, and there will be so there's a phosphate linked to a pentose sugar, and there will be a heterocyclic nitrogen base. So this makes a nucleotide. So a single nucleotide chain, a polynucleotide chain, is RNA, while DNA is a double nucleotide chain. You can see a double helix over here. So it is a spiral in a double helix. And in between, you can see some of the nitrogen base pairs, which are bonded by hydrogen bonding. Okay, that is the structure of DNA. So coming to the components present in nucleic acid, I told you nucleic acids are polynucleotides. Okay, and or I can say nucleotides are the building blocks of nucleic acid. So when a nucleic acid is hydrolyzed, okay, I can say you will be getting the nucleotides. So nucleotides, I told you, it comprises of nucleosides as well as phosphoric acid, phosphate groups. So a single nucleoside, it contains different types of nitrogen bases, two types of purine and two types of pyrimidine base pairs, and a pentose sugar. So this makes a, so this is a nucleoside. This is a nucleoside. So a nucleoside and phosphoric acid combines to form a nucleotide, and when many nucleotides are combined, you'll be getting a nucleic acid. Okay. So this is what I have explained here. You can see in a nucleotide there are three parts. One is a phosphate group. One is a phosphate group. You can see here. This is the phosphate group, and second one there is a pentose sugar, okay, having 5 carbon, and next we'll be having a nitrogen base. Third one is the nitrogen bases, which can be pyrimidine as well as pyrine bases. Okay, so again same thing, there will be a nucleotide contains three parts. One is phosphate, then there is a pentose sugar. So depending upon the sugar, if it is it can be DNA as well as RNA. If it is deoxyribose, it is DNA, and if it is ribose, it will be RNA. And again, coming to the bases, there are two types of bases. One is pyrene base and one is the pyrimidine bases. There are two types of pyrene bases. One is adenine as well as guanine, and similarly pyrimidine bases are cytosine, thymine and uracil. Now again, I told you into its basic structure, I told you there are three segments, that is a pentose sugar and nitrogen bases, pyrene as well as pyrimidine base pairs. So that is called the nucleoside. So this nucleoside, that is nucleoside, is a combination of pentose sugar. Okay, this is a nucleoside. There is a combination of pentose sugar and a heteroscalic base, nitrogen base. So this nucleoside joins with a phosphoric acid or to a phosphate, forms the nucleotide. So phosphate, okay, so phosphate, then sugar, pentose sugar and nitrogen base. So this makes a nucleotide. So this is the nucleotide, this is the nucleotide, this is the nucleotide, this is a nucleoside, this is nucleoside, or I can say nucleoside. Clear? So all these nucleic acid, if it is DNA or RNA, they are polynucleotides. You can see here, what you can see here, we can, for example, you can take phosphoric acid, okay, POH, OH, okay, with another POH, okay, it is H3PO4, okay, it will be H3, phosphoric acid is H3PO4, if you take any pentose sugar, O, be having HOH, H, OH, H, H like this one, again HOH, HOH, this is it is a deoxyribose, CH2OH. CH2OH. So you can see here, it will be on hydrolysis, that one molecule of water will be eliminated. Similarly, if you take any sugar over here, if you take any sugar, for example, let it be cytosine, double bond O NH2. H. Again, you can see the water molecule will be eliminated. So we'll be having a structure like this one. That is, so this OH, this will link to other things. So we'll be having O minus P, and this OH will link to the other nucleotide, that is PO minus. So we'll be having double bond O CH2 okay, and linked to the any base pair. Okay, let it be NH2 itself, NH2 double bond. So this is how a nucleotide chain forms. Okay. So I told you in a DNA it is a double helix. So I told you the base pairs present in DNA is adenine and guanine. Similarly, thymine and cytosine. So here it forms two hydrogen bonds, while this guanine and cytosine forms a three hydrogen bonds. Similarly, in RNA, in spite of thymine, it forms uracil. It forms uracil, and in spite of both guanine and cytosine. So the main difference between the base pairs in DNA and RNA, DNA you can find thymine, you can find thymine in DNA, and thymine is absent in DNA, whereas uracil is present in RNA, and uracil is absent in DNA also. So one of the main difference between DNA and RNA is base pairs in thymine as well as uracil. Another difference between DNA and RNA is the sugar unit. So as the name indicates, DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. So you can see here, so it is a deoxy. You can see here, so you can see here the difference between ribose, it is a OH over here, so it is a deoxy. So this is the pentose sugar present in DNA. So this is the pentose present in DNA, and this ribose is the pentose sugar present in RNA. So this is another difference between DNA as well as RNA. So I told you the different base pairs present in DNA and RNA. I told you some are purine derivatives and some are pyrimidine derivatives. So purine derivatives are adenine and guanine. The purine derivatives are adenine and guanine, and similarly pyrimidine base pairs are C, that is cytosine, U, uracil, and T, thymine. Cut. Okay, that is cytosine, uracil, and thymine. So there are two purine base pairs and three pyrimidine bases, not pairs, bases. So I told you, the phosphate links to the sugar. Okay, you can see here the numbering. You can see here, this is the number one. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this is oxygen over here. There is oxygen. So here you can see that the phosphate group joins to the third carbon of the one sugar. Okay, third carbon of one sugar. Okay, and you can see, and this is a 5, and fifth carbon of the next line. So the phosphate links with the third and fifth carbon of the sugars, of the two consecutive sugar pentose sugars. Third and fifth linkage. Similarly, you can see here the base are attached to the first carbon. Okay, this is the first carbon. If you take any base pair, if you take any base pair, so it attached to the first carbon. This is the first one. This is the first carbon. This is the first carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this one. So phosphate links to the 1, 2, 3, 3 and 5, and the base pairs links to the first carbon of the pentose sugar molecule. So I told you this adenine, okay, adenine, that is purine base pair, always pairs with the pyrimidine thymine. Okay, and guanine always paired with cytosine, that is in DNA. So always you can see that purine and pyrimidine bases are joined by using hydrogen bonds. Okay, so in the case of adenine and thymine, it uses two hydrogen bonds, whereas in the case of guanine and cytosine, it uses three hydrogen bonds to make the bond. So I can say that generally, when I say hydrogen bonding, there are two types of hydrogen bonding. One is intermolecular hydrogen bonding as well as intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So apart from DNA or RNA, protein also contains this intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So protein, both the secondary alpha and beta structure of protein are derived by hydrogen bonding. In the same way, cotton, the chains of cellulose is held together by hydrogen bonding. So you can see here, I told you this guanine and cytosine, they are joined by three hydrogen bonding, while adenine and thymine are by two hydrogen bonding. It is by three hydrogen bonding. So detailed structure can be seen over here. You can see, I told you, always pyrimidine, it is a pyrimidine base joins with the pyrine base. In the case of adenine and thymine, thymine belongs to the pyrimidine and adenine belongs to the pyrine base. Similarly, in the case of cytosine and guanine, cytosine is a pyrimidine, it is a pyrimidine base pair linked to guanine by three hydrogen bond. Guanine is a purine base pair. Okay, that is C, G, and it is T, A. You can see here. And these base pairs are connected to the sugar. It can be ribose or deoxyribose. If it is RNA, it will be ribose. And if it is DNA, it will be deoxyribose. So, we all know that the double helix structure was put forward by the scientists James Watson and Crick. Okay, Watson and Crick, and they obtained a Nobel Prize in 1962 for their invention. So, this double helix, I told you, it is made up of polynucleotides. So, nucleotide means a phosphate, then a sugar and base pairs. So it's a double helix. So again, on the side, again another base. So between there will be two some hydrogen bonds, then base, then sugar and phosphate. So you can see the two strands of polynucleotide. So I told you, apart from DNA, we have RNA. So mainly we have we'll explain three RNA. One is messenger RNA, then ribosome RNA and transfer RNA. So mRNA, so that is messenger RNA, usually it carries the message from DNA from the nucleus into the cytoplasm. So this ribosome RNA, actually it is present in ribosomes. Okay, it gives the structural component for the ribosome. Whereas this transfer RNA, tRNA, usually it is having a clover leaf shape. It is having something like a clover leaf shape. So it delivers amino acid to the growing polypeptide chain. So I will explain during the protein synthesis. From there, you can see what is codon. So it binds with this tRNA binds with the by using its anticodon, it binds with the codons of messenger RNA. Okay, so you will be studying what is anticodon as well as codon. So you have to remember that there are mainly three types of RNA. One is mRNA, one is tRNA, and one is rRNA. Messenger RNA, transfer RNA, and ribosome RNA. Again, the same thing as being explained here, you will be seeing what is the property of mRNA, messenger RNA. So messenger RNA is used as a template to make a proteins. Okay, so it will give a template. From that, on that, the transfer RNA brings its anticodon and this codon and anticodon matches along with the transfer RNA, it two combines with the amino acid, so it matches the amino acid, and so all these amino acids are joined to form a protein chain. Okay, and RNA, that is ribosomal RNA, usually it is present in the ribosome. Okay, that gives the structural component for the ribosome. So these are the properties of these three RNAs: messenger RNA, transfer RNA, and ribosomal RNA. So the main thing regarding the main topic regarding this nucleic acid is its biological functions of nucleic acid. So one is replication, and second is the protein synthesis. So you need to study these two things, that is replication, DNA replication, as well as the protein synthesis. So you can see here, DNA, I told you, usually DNA is a double strand. Okay, it will unwind to a single strand. So by the process of replication, you can make two new DNAs. So usually DNA is made up of two strands, okay, twisted around each other in a double helix shape. So each strand is made up of a sequence of four bases, okay, representing the represented by the letters A, C, G, and T. The two strands are complementary in each other. Okay, so it is the base pairs are complementary in each other. If a T is in one strand, there will be A in the other strand. Similarly, if C, cytosine, in one strand, there will be guanine in the other strand. So in the replication, the first step is DNA in the DNA replication is to separate or unwind the two strands. First, it will be, you can see here, it will be unwinding. So this is the first step. It will be unwinding, or it will be separated into two strands. So this unzipping is done by an enzyme called helicase. Okay, it is done in the presence of a enzyme called helicase. So the separated strands each provide a template for creating a new strand of DNA. So again, enzyme DNA polymerase by using the enzyme is the second step. So DNA polymerase by the enzyme DNA polymerase. Okay, by using the enzyme DNA polymerase, now adds complementary DNA bases in one direction and forming forming two new DNA. So this is the DNA replication. Okay, and next one, the main important thing regarding biological function of nucleic acid is the protein synthesis. So the protein synthesis, before explaining this one, it involves two steps. One is transcription, and the other one is translation, and the other one is translation. Okay, so these are the two steps involved in protein synthesis. So you can see here, the first step of a protein synthesis involves the transcribing the genetic information in DNA to a complementary RNA, that is mRNA, messenger RNA. So you can see that the DNA makes a complementary thing, that is mRNA. So this messenger RNA, okay, so this messenger RNA from nucleus will come to the cytoplasm. So usually the enzyme RNA polymerase, okay, again we need an enzyme over here, the enzyme RNA polymerase attached to the gene, it moves along the DNA, making a strand of messenger RNA. Okay, so this messenger RNA, so okay, as a complementary part of gene. So this mRNA, so now comes out of the nucleus to the cytoplasm. Okay, so what happens is, out of the so this mRNA is formed from the free bases in DNA strand as a complementary by using as a complementary bases. For example, if you think the bases in DNA, I am writing the bases in DNA is bases in DNA. Let it be A, G, C, T, etc. So corresponding to this one, it will form a messenger RNA. So corresponding bases will be the corresponding or the complementary corresponding the complementary bases in mRNA will be U, okay, that is uracil, because RNA is having uracil, C, G, A, etc. So from DNA, okay, from DNA or from gene, so this section of DNA responsible for the protein synthesis is called gene. From this free bases in DNA strand, a complementary bases are added to the mRNA. This is called the transcription. Yeah, this is called the, so it is transcribing into the messenger RNA. So this mRNA, this messenger RNA can form a template for making the protein. I'll explain how it is formed. So next step is the translation. So the mRNA then moves out of the nucleus into cytoplasm. Okay, so from here the mRNA is coming to the cytoplasm. Okay, moves out of the nucleus into cytoplasm. So the ribosome in the cytoplasm binds to the mRNA. Okay, binds to the, so this is the ribosome, binds to the mRNA. The ribosome reads the code in mRNA to produce a chain made up of amino acids. You can see here a transfer RNA, a tRNA, that is the transfer RNA, tRNA. tRNA molecules carry the amino acid to the ribosome, and the mRNA reads the three bases at a time, and a tRNA delivers the corresponding amino acid to the growing chain. And finally, a amino acid chain, a long chain of amino acid is formed, and the amino acid chain folds into a complex 3D shape protein. Okay, so you can see here another picture. So what happens? So for example, I told you, you can see here, this is the messenger RNA. I will explain once again, this is the messenger RNA. So it gets a template from the DNA, and it comes out of the nucleus into the cytoplasm. So in presence of ribosome, so this mRNA is a template for the protein synthesis. So what you can see is the tRNA, transfer RNA, okay, it is having some of its anticodon. You can see these are the anticodon of tRNA, and these are the codons of mRNA. Okay, so complementary base pairs are joined. So this tRNA will be holding a amino acid. So when this tRNA, when this anticodon of tRNA and the codon of mRNA matches each other, so it will link the amino acid to the growing amino acid chain, and this will move out. So like that, another tRNA along with the amino acid comes to the mRNA site. Both the anticodon as well as codon will resonates each other, will resonates each other, and they makes a bond, and again an amino acid is being attached to the growing chain, and the transfer RNA moves away. So like that, you can see here, so this is the messenger RNA. For example, if we have this is the codon of okay, this is the codon GGC. GGC is the one codon. Okay, GGC. So I am explaining the translation. So corresponding to the anticodon of tRNA is CCG. So this is the anticodon for the tRNA. So when these are matches, I told you the so this transfer RNA is combined with a amino acid. For example, this is glycine. The anticodon of this transfer RNA is CCG, and the codon, the corresponding codon for mRNA is GGC. So when it finds the corresponding codon and anticodon, corresponding C and anticodon, it binds, and along with the binding, what happens? The amino acid present in the transfer RNA will attach to the growing amino acid chain. So like that, new amino acids will keep growing like this one, and finally this amino acid grow into a complex three-dimensional structure. So this is how a protein is being synthesized. So next, you can see I told you what is a gene. I told you a part of DNA is called gene. So usually genetic code, the amino acid sequence in every synthesized protein is predetermined by the base sequence in DNA molecule, which is transcribed to the mRNA. So I told you the part of gene, okay, which used in the transcribing into mRNA, which is used in transcribing for mRNA, is called, so this mRNA is called the gene. So this is the gene. So I can say the nucleotide base sequence of DNA that specifies the amino acid sequence of protein is known as a genetic code. So each segment of a DNA that codes for a specific protein is called a gene. So I told you, so for making a protein, we needed tRNA, and tRNA can be joined only with respect to mRNA. So this mRNA is formed in the nucleus with respect to the DNA. The segments required to form this mRNA, this one, this code, the code required to form mRNA, the base code required to form mRNA is called the gene. So gene, actually gene is a part of DNA which required for protein synthesis and which carries the genetic information. Okay. And let us come to the test for DNA and RNA. I told you in both the case of DNA and RNA, it differs with respect to the sugar unit, pentose sugar. In one case it is ribose, in the other case it is deoxyribose. For DNA, I told you DNA, it is a deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay, when this DNA is heated with diphenylamine, in an acid solution, it gives a blue color. This is because this deoxyribose present in this one, in presence of an acid, it forms a hydroxylevulinic acid, which is in blue complex form, which forms a blue complex with the diphenylamine. Similarly for RNA, okay, RNA again presence of acid, okay, RNA it do contain ribose, okay, so that is ribose in presence of an acid, okay, it forms furfural, it forms a furfural. So this furfural, when reacts with the arsenol, arsenol is the 5-methyl, 1,3-dihydroxybenzene. Okay, so with the arsenol and in presence of ferric chloride, FeCl3, it forms a green color. So these are the two tests for DNA as well as RNA. So now we can see different difference between the DNA and RNA. Initially, you can say DNA is a double strand, RNA is a single strand. Okay, DNA, the sugar unit is deoxyribose, whereas in the case of RNA, it is ribose. Okay, in DNA, usually the base pairs are all these things. Okay. Cytosine, guanine, and adenine, all these three are common for both. Okay. Apart from this one, thymine is also present in DNA. So the bases in DNA are thymine, cytosine, guanine, and adenine. Whereas in the case of RNA, the bases are cytosine, guanine, adenine, and uracil. Okay. And some other difference is that DNA, the pairing of bases is only found throughout the molecule. Whereas the hydrogen bonding or the base pairing is found only in certain segments, especially in the helical segments. So usually RNA you cannot find the base pairing. Only in some cases, some helical segments only you can find the base pairing. So next point is that the total amount of purine base pairs as well as pyrimidine base pairs is always in the equal ratio, 1:1. Equal amount of purine as well as pyrimidine are a pair. Whereas in the case of RNA, the total amount of purine need not to be equal with the pyrimidine bases. And DNA is mostly found in the nucleus of the cell, while RNA is found throughout the cell, especially in the cytoplasm. DNA replicates while RNA does not replicate. DNA contains the genetic information which transcribes into RNA and thereby control the protein synthesis, whereas RNA does not hold any kind of genetic information. Moreover, it is involved in only in the protein synthesis. Okay. So these are the things regarding nucleic acid. Hope you understand the topic. Thank you.